Change? Shit. I guess change is good for any of us. Whatever it takes for any of y'all niggas to get up out the hood. Shit, I'm with you. I ain't mad at you. Got nothing but love for you. Do your thing, boy. Yeah. All the homies that I ain't talked to in a while, I'ma send this one out for y'all. Know what I mean? Cause I ain't mad at you. Heard y'all tearing up shit out there. Kicking up dust, giving a motherfuck. Yeah, niggas. Cause I ain't mad at you. Now we was once two niggas of the same kind. Quick to holler at a hoochie with the same line. You was just a little smaller, but you still roll. Got stressed to YA and hit the hood swole. Remember when you had a Jerry curl, didn't quite learn. On the block with your Glock, tripping off Sherm. Collect calls to the tilt, saying how you changed. Oh, you a Muslim now, no more dope game. Heard you might be coming home, just got bail. Wanna go to the mosque, don't wanna chase tail. It seems I lost my little homie, he's a changed man. Hit the pen and now no sinning is the game plan. When I talk about money, all you see is the struggle. When I tell you I'm living large, you tell me it's trouble. Congratulations on the wedding. I hope your wife knows she got a player for life. And that's no bullshitting. I know we grew apart, you probably don't remember. I used to fiend for your sister, but never went up in her. And I can see us after school, we bomb on the first motherfucker with the wrong shit on. Now the whole shit's changed, and we don't even kick it. Got a big money scheme. And you ain't.
Motherfucker, you see 106-year-old motherfucker down there twerking. That's my grandmama. Free grandmama, free G mama. Hell yeah. That's right. But now my grandmama, you know, take care of yourself, because my grandmama had diabetes and they cut both of her legs off around her knees. And I used to take her down to my granddaddy's grave and put flowers on the grave, stuff like that. But one day I seen some shit that I thought it was a ghost. I took off running. I ain't gonna lie, I'm a punk ass nigga. I left my grandmama down there in a wheelchair with no knees. I got halfway up the hill. I said, oh shit, I left my grandmama. She said, you a motherfucking lie. She running on them nerves. God damn. Nigga, I remember the worst ass whooping I got. I asked my grandmama, Grandmama, I want to buy you some shoes for Christmas. What size shoe you wear?
No.
My mama was like, I'm 20 piece. Do we have any more comedians that's going to come up? Because I was going to introduce one of my hottest artists. I'm going to just say his name because y'all might not know him, but I know him. What up, Mimic the Rebel? Just throw your hands up, baby. I got two more hot comedians. I got somebody that need a fire extinguisher. I got another comedian coming up right now. This dude right here, he done been all the way to Iraq. You know what I'm saying? He's a killer. That's all I can say. Don't fuck with him. Don't heckle him. Cause this nigga, he fought three people in the crowd before. And I didn't know what to do. I ain't had no bun money or nothing. I'ma just give it to him.
Flame!
No music.
Well, hell. How y'all doing up there tonight? Shit, yeah, we ain't had a game on Monday night. Right here? Right there, there I am. Hell yeah. Shout out to the guy there was a Walmart the other day, and shout out to the line, and that little girl, that little bit ass girl, told her grandma this dude, she smelled something, dude farted. And the grandma said, I told the dude I apologize to you because, you know, she shouldn't have said that. And the little girl said, well, grandma, why you apologize when he did fart? I seen his pants move. Shit. Yeah. He let it out, grandma. Yeah, he did it. I saw his pants move. Alright. Damn, everybody in the damn world went out when I stepped on the motherfucker. What the fuck going on? Couple of them rats back up in this motherfucker. But that's alright. Can't get them back in? I don't give a damn. Hell. You know what? You men is the reason that messed up the whole world. Y'all mess around and got these women out there pussy lanes and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, women say all men dicks ain't the same. Hell, I say all women pussy ain't the same. Well, all women pussy ain't the same. Hell no. You got pussy for motherfucking ain't a goddamn elf. You know? The sign of an elf pussy, a pussy a nigga don't want. Nigga don't want no women with no elf pussy. Hell no. Deep pussy is all right. But you gotta make a nigga get it, you know? You know what I'm saying? But it's goddamn, you know, but, you know, C and B and F and A and all that shit, you know, that's how niggas actually rape pussies for real, women. No lie, they really do. You know what I'm saying? But back to what I was talking about, the reason why it got about the lane, because, you know, you don't supposed to treat all pussies the same. You know what I'm saying? Competing is based on the grade of the pussy. You know what I'm saying? You can't take no damn D grade pussy to the motherfucking high Reese. You know what I'm saying? Her ass need to go to Motel 6 or 8. That's where she reside. She can't have no vacations either. Hell no. See, you take, no, you can't get no damn D lady, no damn gold, diamonds and shit. She deserve goddamn plastic jewelry. That's what she's supposed to get, plastic jewelry and shit. And, you know, you gotta learn, you know, you treat the A and the B, that's the quality shit. You know what I'm saying? They get nice shit in life. But I'm telling you about women, a man only treats you based on how you feel, good you feel about your pussy, you know what I'm saying? Now you don't know where you stand on how you feel about your coochie or how he treats you. Then you can move on and stay. One or the other don't make no difference to him. You know, but he really looking for that snapper, you know what I'm saying? You know how women always looking for that big dick? Men looking for that snapper. Snapper is the damn thing of life for a man. Nigga his whole life looking for snapper. Once he finds snapper, you know he got snapper. He always smiling. You see, if you see a nigga always smiling all the time, either one got that snapper. You know what I'm saying? Hell yeah, got. You know, she win all the arguments because he don't give a fuck. But he got the snapper at the house. He know the snapper is better than motherfucking CB and you know, hey, he got the real shit at the house. You don't want to lose that. That's why the nigga go to jail. Never been a man go to jail over pussy. He going to jail over some snapper. Ain't lying. Over going to prison over that snapper coochie. And that snapper coochie make me do any damn time. I know a dude, snapper coochie make him give his whole damn wife. Whole wife. And they couldn't even get away to work and shit. She took all his damn money. You know, I ain't like that though. I ain't one to get pussy whipped, you know what I'm saying? And you know, if I look at like this, women be talking about how my pussy, I got the pussy. Well hell, what you think the dick is? Dick ain't no good? Hell, my dick is just as good as your pussy, that's what I'm saying. One don't work without the other.
Freaks.
Hey, my dick, your pussy, hey, happy life. One don't work without the other. I think, you know what I'm saying? Bragging on, let her brag on her shit. I said, well, hell, bitch, you done had two C-sections. Hey, what the hell you bragging on your pussy, bud? You done had two C-sections. You ain't getting that shit ain't worth about 35 cents. You bragging on your shit. You got C-section pussy. Nobody want that shit no more. Hell no, nobody wants it no more. Nobody wants it no more. I remember I had this girl one time. I was trying to get her for 3 damn years. You know, you on the hunt, man. I hunted one for 3 years. I finally took her to my house. She finally gave in. Get the damn man on the floor plate. You know how you supposed to use the fingers and shit? Oh, the motherfucker, it was already there. Goddamn whole big man, goddamn coffee can and shit. I know, hell no. I ain't telling her out loud like that, but in my mind, I said, oh, hell no. She said, it's still tight. And that's when I spoke up. I said, hell, I never know. I ain't fucking with it. Hell no. Nope. Ain't never seen no shit like this. I put out my house. She said, you ain't gonna do it? I said, hell no. I said, ain't never seen no. There might be a nigga down there in the goddamn fuck 18 wheeler down there somewhere. I can't go down in that shit. Hell no, I can't. Go to hell now looking down and that shit like that. I had a girl one time, her coochie was white. Solid white.
White woman?
No, she was no white, she was a sister. No. I mean, you know, her coochie's in pink inside. Her shit was white.
Infected.
It was infected? Oh, shit. I hit that motherfucker, though. I hit that motherfucker. And yeah, who good, too? Fuck y'all. Infected by AIDS.
ride to an 18-wheeler, dip the rag in there and wipe y'all with the diesel gas.
No, no, we don't diesel gas, man. The girl just, she was a nice woman. She was very respectful. She just had white coaching. Maybe she was better than white women, and it didn't mean race or something. I don't know, but the shit was pure white. I'm talking about snow white, not no damn, you know, hair white. She was straight white.
Bleach that shit.
Oh, no, okay, well, shit, let's go, man. I'm doing that. It was some good bleach coaching. That's all I'm saying. Motherfucker was straight bleach coaching. Good. Know what I'm saying? So it worked out. I'll tell you one thing. Women will let you go, man. Hey, now, women, when they get tired of your ass cheating, you ain't gonna get no more cheating. When they say it's overdone and all that, that's what the hell they mean. They call it outro. And that's when they'll talk about your ass in front of anybody. Your crushed ass bastard, damn weak ass, goddamn no job ass, having motherfucker can't hold a job, raggedy clothes, stinking mouth, rusty dick, wrinkled nuts, all that shit. They'll say everything about you, no lie. Goddamn tweezle dick ass. And matter of fact, I got some advice, but you need to learn how to cheat up instead of cheat down. I see that skaggy you left me for. Hell yeah, all that shit talking about. Just talk about you. Something just terrible. Just terrible. Stank, motherfucking ass, your nuts stank. Don't want a nigga suck your dick and your nuts stanking all over the goddamn place. Don't wash that. He don't even wash his ass and shit. Hell, I bought a motherfucker some brand new soap and he didn't wash his goddamn ass. Go cut the bed. Won't have his nut and suck and all that shit. I said, you know what, fellas, this is how it is, baby. In 2019, even though you was wrong, even though you got caught cheating, don't take that shit laying down. Hell no. As you know, crack on me, and you know I do jokes for a living. You lost your goddamn mind, girl. I said, what about the time your big ass was walking through the goddamn hallway, your ass dripping so long, had to pick that motherfucker up and catch with your motherfucker crushed ass? What about that damn time? Okay, what about that time we was in bed and I was getting up to go to the bathroom and stepped on your motherfucking titty that was on the outside of the bed? Oh, what a long titty ass, huh? What about that? Shit. Hell yeah. What about you talking nasty? I gave your ass a goddamn white negligee before we went to bed. We got through the motherfucker with polka dot. Who the hell nasty? Your ass nasty. That's what I told you. I said, your goddamn coochie take like goddamn 3-day-old collard green juice. I went down that motherfucker and take like 3-day-old collard green juice. And you talking about, I'm there. You need to wash your goddamn decrepit ass pussy out, bitch. That's what you need to do. Hell, and the reason I left your ass because your coochie look like chickens. Who the hell want to mess with a bitch with goddamn coochie look like chickens, bitch? Don't you ever try to talk about me and my job with a goddamn crack on a motherfucker. Hell wrong with you. That's what I told her. Damn right, so did. Hell yeah, I'm giving y'all just one more. I'm out of here. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Shit. And you know, I was coming up. I was in the military. You was in the military, wasn't you?
No, sir.
Yeah, you was. You was out of date. No, you ain't the same motherfucker. You was. You was in the military. Anyway, whoever was in the military, I was in the military in Germany. My ex-wife being like, she was in one of them combat units and shit. So I had to take care of the kids. So hell, I'm going to decide to cook some chicken and shit one day. Cook this chicken an hour and a half. So that means I ain't doing nobody cooking no goddamn chicken. I put the chicken in front of my kids. My damn daughter bit down in the chicken. And blood started coming down her mouth. And she started hollering, Daddy, Daddy, blood, blood, blood. And just jumped up on the table, left the chicken at the damn table. Yes, she did. Hell yeah. No lie. I was over in Frisco last week at the goddamn mall over there. And I've been curious about them women with them long ass nails. Man, you got long nails? Them women with them real long ass nails. You know, them long ass nails. You know what I'm saying? One, you can see, a lot of people can't see them long ass nails. And people can't be curious about them long ass nails, right? So it was an African lady. I walked up over nice and kind and polite. Tapped on the shoulder. I said, oh, ma'am, I've been curious about people with them long nails for a long damn time. You know what I'm saying? A long damn time. And I don't want to be too disrespectful, and I don't think I'm being disrespectful, but the curiosity I always had, How do you wipe your ass with damn, that damn long? She said, well, how your mammy wipe her ass? How your mammy wipe her ass? Hey, I'm sorry. Oh, I ain't sorry. Goddamn. You said, how your mammy wipe her ass? I said, hold up. My mama ain't got nothing to do with this shit. I asked you a simple ass damn question. That deserves a simple ass answer.
How you doing?
And I know what the deal is. I'm gonna tell you what the deal is, lady. You don't never wipe your ass, cause you cannot wipe your ass with your fingernails that long. If you got an ass wiping machine in your purse,
tell them how to do it.
Or you just pat your ass. Now if you pat your ass, that means you stink, bitch.
Preach, nigga, preach.
Cause I tell you, pat, you got them flies hanging on the back of your ass right now. What? That's why we know you stink. So let me tell you, if you got anybody at your job, anybody everywhere, if you see them, then you got the right to call them stank bitch. Hell yeah. Stank bitch hoe. Flame out. That's it. Flame out. Don't give it, bro.
Hey, dog.
Flame is finished.
Oh, shit. Hello.
He said,
oh, shit.
That's it.
Yeah.
Y'all give it up for Flame. He brought up some valid points. How do you wipe your ass with your nails? And why was that nigga wearing a wave cap and he got a bald head? That's what I was saying. That nigga bald head, we got a wave cap on. That shit popped up like a bug. I got scared and shit. We got another comedian coming up. This guy right here been doing comedy for 10 years. Bring it, goddammit, bring it. This man right here coming up next is Mr. Larry E.
Yeah, what's up? Give up a flame, baby. And the host. Alright, give up a flame, throw my pussy and shit. Play bitch, oh shit, flame, damn. Pussy, if you want to fuck a bitch, you know about pussy, how they flame. If Nick Saban would have saw her, what he said, that nigga wouldn't be on TV and shit. I'm just saying, flame. Funny as shit, bro. I love you. Y'all good tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Shit, I've been doing comedy for a little while and shit. I'm all right. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? One thing I'm going to tell you now, the flame said a lot of ghetto ass shit, but I'm going to tell y'all right now, I don't fuck with ghetto ass females. I stopped doing that shit. You know why I stopped fucking with ghetto ass females? Because they're ghetto ass fucking kids. I can't do that shit. Remember that baby kids and shit? Remember that shit? I fucked with a ghetto ass female, went to her damn apartment, and that damn kid was ghetto than a motherfucker. The 2-year-old kid was outside with a snot ass nose, with a dirty paper riding a 10 speed. What the fuck you doing riding a damn 10 speed at 2 years old? I was damn 10 when I learned how to ride a goddamn 10 speed. I'm like, god damn, that's a ghetto ass motherfucking kid. Bad ass motherfucker, man. You know the kid bad because he was talking shit. He's talking shit with that raspy ass voice. You heard the raspy ass voice like he been smoking cigarettes when he was still inside his mama womb and shit? Check this out, player, check this out. He was saying some ghetto ass shit. I didn't understand. Hey, player, if you gonna be fucking with my mama, don't be fighting on her. I'm like, what the fuck is fighting on some damn body? About fighting with somebody and fighting against somebody. What the fuck is fighting on somebody? I mean, fighting on my mama. And on top of that, you gonna have to make groceries. How the fuck you gonna make groceries? I heard about buying groceries, selecting groceries. How the fuck you gonna make fucking groceries? How you make groceries? Some ghetto ass shit, y'all. Y'all know y'all seen that shit. Y'all seen it. Y'all fucking seen it. And then his damn mama, oh my god, she was ghetto than a motherfucker too. I'm about to follow Flame. I wasn't gonna cuss and shit, but fucking Flame started this shit. But her mama was ghetto. She was ghetto, she was smart, she was intriguing, and she was ghetto. Cause she had a conversation with a girlfriend and shit didn't make no fucking sense. Didn't make sense. It started off bad. She answered the phone. Ta-da-ding. Girl, what you want? Don't call me no more. I'm like, god damn, you want to talk to this bitch or not? What you going to talk to or not? Don't call her, what you want? Then the crazy part about it is she started getting like smart on me and shit. She said, I already know she got psychic. He already slapped you. I'm like, damn, this bitch is smart. She must have went to cosmetology school or some shit to be that damn smart. How you know they going to smack you already? She said, then she started counseling. Said, listen, bitch, if he slapped you 3 times, that means he loves you.
Preach, nigga, preach.
So nigga slapped you 3 times and mean he loves you. What the fuck the first 2 slaps for? You know what I'm saying?
A like you.
Nah, this bitch be tripping and shit. You know, I don't think I'd be fucking with her like that, man. Fuck that shit. Nah, she took that second slap like a man and shit. I'm feeling that shit, though. I might want to fuck with her, though. I might want to fuck with her. Nigga, that's my bitch. That's my damn bitch. She took three slaps. That's my bitch. I'm fucking with her. All I'm saying is, I didn't understand. I stopped fucking with her, though. You know what? Hold on, shit. What kind of... We good? I'm in the wrong area? And I'm glad summertime is over with. Hey, what's up, player? Player, right there. Bald head, the socks and shit. I ain't fucking with you, though. I ain't fucking with her. Hey, I'm glad summer's over with because I made a lot of fucking mistakes this summer. A lot of fucking mistakes. One mistake I made over and over and over is picking the fucking wrong watermelon. Does anybody here know how to pick the right fucking watermelon? I'm gonna ask some people right now. Do you know how to pick the right watermelon, sir?
Do I know how to do what?
Pick the right watermelon.
Pick the right watermelon?
Yes.
Sure.
What the f-
Sure. Sure.
Okay, explain it to everybody out there in the audience. How do you pick the right watermelon, you?
Okay, so it's green, and then it got them little lines going to fuck down it.
Nigga.
I fucking pick it with this red, with the white lines. And then you gotta shake it, and then if it don't move.
He said you gotta shake it.
Wrong. Man, how you pick the right watermelon? Wrong. Fuck, I got the mic. I'm funny. Watch, check this out. This is how you pick the fucking right watermelon. Y'all ready for this shit? You go inside of a store, and you choose the watermelon you want. Pick that bitch up and run out with them motherfuckers.
Oh,
if they don't chase you, it's not the right watermelon. They ain't gonna chase no bad watermelon. All I'm saying is, you gotta pick the right watermelon. I made a lot of bad mistakes this summer. Another bad mistake I made is, I took advice from the wrong people, all right? All right, check this out, y'all. No offense, white people. I see y'all in here, no offense. Was it what, half or three of y'all in here? Listen, a white man told me it's more than one way to skin a cat. Have y'all heard that shit before? I'm a black man. That's an Asian people shit. I don't skin cats. The only cats I fuck with one between women legs. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about, baby? Okay, move on then. Getting old. A lot of people here getting old too. Anybody here in their 40s? Fit, okay. See, that's when you know you're getting old. Because you start telling motherfuckers that you're in your 40s, your 50s. You know what I'm saying? When you're young, you tell them, hey, I'm 25. I was born 19, whatever, whatever, whatever. But when you get old, you say, hey, I'm in my 40s, my 50s. Getting old, man. I realize I'm getting old because the other day I farted and I caught a cramp. I thought I was having a menstrual cycle. I was like, oh, shit. God damn. This motherfucker gonna be heavy right here. This gonna be a heavy ass cycle right here. Damn, I'm gonna have to get the maxi pads and the purple package. The purple package. It's gonna be some heavy bleeding on the purple package. God damn. Whoo! I thought I was three meals dilated when I damn had that day before. I said, you know what, man? I'm off and have a damn way on this shit. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go on and kill it right there because I lost everybody. You know what I'm saying? I'm seeing it. That's when you know you're doing comedy for a while. When you saying some shit you think is supposed to be funny, and everybody start doing some extra shit like, hey, I see that pimple on my ass right now. That's the one I see in that girl. And they start doing extra shit. Or when you look at somebody and they laugh and do this, ha ha. Oh shit, this thing is fucking up. It loses time. All right, you know what? Let's go ahead and kill it right there. My name is Larry E. I'm glad y'all came out, all two of y'all. I'll be again here again next time. Get some damn chicken tenders so I can have some chicken tenders to shit. Larry, I love y'all. Shout out to all the comedians. I'm out.
Y'all give it up one more time for Mr. Derrick E. Damn, say baby, that's good, man. You got anything you do, you gotta stay with it. If you pick up cans, you gotta know the goddamn trash cans that throw away a lot of cans. You gotta do, you gotta be consistent with it. I thought I seen Deion Sanders walk up in this bitch while ago. I was like, goddamn, what's up? Man, I stole this shit from JJ's. He would call me this morning like, I can never let you in my house again. I will miss you, my precious.
Why did you have my shirt?
And you know you can't, well shit, I can't wear no large. So we got one more comedian. This nigga always show up late and shit. I fussed at him after the first shot. But this nigga funny as hell. I'm talking about this one other.
We coming.
This nigga was so funny in school, man.
Baby.
Me and him got suspended because we made the principal pee on ourselves. I want to bring up my homeboy.
Show him.
Mr. Ron Funny.
Show him glory.
And let me tell you a story about Ron Funny. One day we got so motherfucking high. Nigga, both of us woke up in a pigeon coop and we was blaming each other like, what you doing to that shit? I was like, nigga, what you do to that shit? He was like, no, you had to lace that shit. I smoke
it's about
any day.
To be in a minute. It ain't over
yet. He don't want to come up. We'll bring him up later. TAC.
You ain't never been to
TAC.
Baby, look. Baby, look.
What's up, TAC, baby? Trap House, motherfucking culture. This just ain't no. This a way of life. Sorry.
We on our way.
These niggas don't lie, they ain't been trapped for real.
That's why I keep
my damn skirt and pray for them every day. Oh, I got my little princess in the house. This is the Trap House Princess. This is my little baby, little princess. I forgot your name. I just called you Little Blue, baby. You solid, baby. Give it up for Juju. Look, I love this lady right here. She's so sweet. Like I said, Juju is a great person. I hope she make it alive. I gotta give a shout out to OG. This dude will buy you a drink, but don't drink that shit. Don't drink the drink again.
No,
I'm
a 360 individual.
We're gonna ride with you. Yeah, you can
ride in the car with you. Put it in the dirty. You gotta
come back this way. Yeah, you gotta come back this way.
You got that throwback on.
Got that throwback jersey on. JJ, let me come to his house and this is what. Yeah. Watch out, I work out, baby.
You
want
to go have some more
food? Nigga, no, you want to go back a bit.
I know.
Dirty
mouth. She's like,
oh, no. I don't know.
I'll show you.
She on my tax office.
You
want to
get beat up
or not? That Pittsburgh Steelers versus Atlanta Falcons. TAC to the stage. Y'all give it up for the hottest new artist in America. We ain't gonna just say it, DFW. Hottest new artist in America, TAC. We got it.
Hey,
man. Mimic the Rebel, I need you to come to the stage, baby. I need you to come to the stage.
It's just a floor.
I need you to come to the stage, baby. That's a part of you. You know it. You know it.
Work out, work out. You know it, you know it, you know it, you know it. Hey, watch how I work out. I get the power, watch I ship it out. Hey, I'm in your bitch, watch how I work out. I'm Camp Blue, I'm a book now. I want that money, no cap. I'm punching me, walking to bitch now. Turn that bitch up like a good talk. I'm turn that bitch up like a stripper. Watch how I work out. Watch how I work. Watch how I work out. Watch how I work out. Watch how I work, watch how I work out, hey. Watch how I work out, watch how I work, watch how I work out, hey. Watch how I work out, watch how I work, watch how I work out, watch how I work out. I hit the new bitch and I shit by out. I beat that pen like a ram. I'm all about peace like a pan. Having my chips in my case. I'm giving this shit like it's lame. With the fingers to the hate. Work the block, work the pot. Beat that bitch up to a lock. Middle fingers for the cops. Fuck that shit, I'm on the block. Paying my money, my guap. She twerking at that, she won't stop. Little cheese, right? Cheese, right? She pop. Watch how she work on that pole, she won't guap. She clapping that bitch to the top. Work out, work out, boo. Don't get that. Be more careful. Hey!
I'll still be more careful.
Gotta be more careful. Alright! I came up here and did a little therapy for myself. That was more so for me than you. I hope you got yours, but I damn sure got mine. You hear me? So we gonna call the host back in, Mr. 20 Piece Durham. We're gonna keep the party rocking, keep it rolling. Alright, so we're gonna call the next comedian to the stage. All the way from out of town. Came up here to put it down. The one, the only, Junkyard Dog! Put your goddamn hands together. Yeah. I could understand that if I was a black guy.
Just in case, you're not that dog. They see you. You can back on the court, they still see you. You going.
Oh my goodness.
We're dancing?
Two steps.
Say two steps. You gotta move.
That's tough.
Great.
Come on,
Junkyard
Dog.
Yeah. Just come on. Now that we got that shit out the way. Yeah.
The last time I took the knee, the bitch said yes.
Damn. You shouldn't be messing with dog, Junkyard Dog.
Getting old sucks.
All right.
I guess for you more sensitive types, getting old creates negative pressure. Now you explain to me why you can be too old to cut the mustard, but you never get too old to cut the cheese.
Hello, hello, Prince.
Getting old sucks, but that's okay. The AARP is looking out for me. Yeah, all the time trying to sell me shit I don't need. Oh, you need a life insurance policy to cover your burial expenses. No, I don't. I got land.
Hello.
I got a tractor.
Hello.
Uh-oh.
Dig a fucking hole. There's plenty of wood over there by the tool shed. Build a box. 7 feet long, 3 feet wide, 18 inches deep. You better make it 19, brother. I might want to tip my hat while I'm in there. And the reason I want to tip my hat is because not everybody that comes to your grave is going to piss on it. Getting old sucks.
Yeah.
Gotta go to the damn doctor. The doctors hate me. They hate me because I tell them the damn truth. I went to the doctor the other day and he told me, oh, your cholesterol is high. Well, no shit, Sherlock. We slumped a bowl before we left the house. And he asked me, was I drinking bottled water? Hang on, I gotta get my prop right here. He asked me, was I drinking bottled water? And I said, yeah, I'm drinking bottled water. He said, well, not all bottled water is the same. What brand are you drinking? Budweiser. And then he tells me, he says, oh, I see your optometrist report, and you're going blind. What the fuck's wrong with him? And the doctor says, oh, your optometrist says you're going blind in your right eye. What are you planning to do about that? Well, my damn sure ain't switching hands at this point.
Stop.
I know it's rough, man, by age for you to believe such a thing. But let me tell you something, sweetheart. It's not just the sun that rises.
I'm drinking Budweiser.
Okay. That's one of my favorites, and I can't
all right, let me get my position guy here.
Not the refrigerator, the fridge down.
Look at that dollar. I love it. Getting old sucks.
Hello.
Dating at my age. That's a real challenge. Out where I live, you can see the stars pretty good. And me and the old gal were laying out there on the deck, and I said, oh, look, there's Orion's Belt. And she ran her hand down my breeches and said, oh, it's a little different.
It's all right.
I got a new girlfriend. But she didn't last too long.
What?
She failed an oral exam.
Oh, shit.
I asked her, was she any kin to Monica Lewinsky, but she said no.
Oh, shit. Bitch, what?
And then, on top of all this, I was rejected by eHarmony.
Oh, hell no.
They didn't like my username. It was $5 foot long.
Oh, no.
answered all your questions right. We asked you what was the one thing about a woman that really does it for you. Well, I answered that question. Callus is on her knees.
Oh my God!
Hey, get your mind out of the gutter. There ain't nothing wrong with a woman that prays a lot. To the big guy.
Oh, Lord!
And I say, well, you know, I could change that to pistol grip ears. Well, how about nipples like a 44 Magnum?
Oh, shit.
Nippelodeon. Always was my favorite channel. All I need now is a woman that likes dick at night.
Yes.
And then everybody says, oh, you got to get a smartphone. My daughter got me one, set it all up, gave it to me, and didn't teach me shit how to use it. She calls me about a week later and she says, hey Dad, how you liking that smartphone? Well, that son of a bitch ain't smart. It woke me up at 5:30 a.m. to tell me flash good warning. Flood my ass, I ain't been flashed one single time. That was a kid. And then he keeps telling me, updates available. At my age, updates means she can still reach her nipples. Updates available. Updating in my age means her ass does not remind me of the moon. Dust. Craters. Poisonous gases. Not much gravity. Nothing really being drawn toward it other than flies. And it too had a dark side. I'm gonna lighten up on y'all a little bit. Y'all remember about 10 years ago when you had the census?
Yes.
Coming this year. And believe me, I had me some fun with them. I told them three people lived there. But I only gave them one name. It gets crowded under it. And then they asked me a question about race. I drew me a box. I checked it. And I wrote Daytona 500 out there. That's my race.
Hello.
I've been trying to find a way to keep Jehovah's Witness away from my door. I put up an NRA flag. Got me some sandbags. Built me a machine gun nest. What worked was that one-legged blow-up doll strapped butt up in the tire swing. And that half gallon of empty, that half KY jelly sitting there in the fork of the tree.
Oh, no.
Hey, don't judge me. It repels Jehovah's Witness, census workers, and the neighbors keep their damn kids out of my yard. Yeah. Where are my Cowboy fans?
Yes, sir.
Yay. Hey, JB. Yeah. JB, what up?
Thank God you got a side door.
JJ, put him out. That dude over there.
Now, I got a little advice for everybody. Not just Cowboy fans, particularly not the Cowboy fans. But between the months of September and the end of December, and I say the end of December because the Cowboys don't play much in January. But during that time, do not ask a Dallas Cowboy fan to give you change for a dollar. Chances are they're going to have trouble with that fourth quarter.
Oh, okay.
Let him fucking know.
Okay, so now he got a new individual to give
out.
Now he got
one. Y'all want to talk about football? Now, ladies, if you're going to go get you some aftermarket titties,
oh, shit. Aftermarket titties.
Get you some inflatable ones. Get you some, I can check with a tire gauge. You see, I want the best of both worlds. Part of me prefers them tightly inflated, and the other part of me is kind of like Tom Brady. Nobody was deflated gay for that. Man. I thought y'all were football fans. Yeah.
Hello.
TV commercials piss y'all off? TV commercials piss you up? Now explain to me what marketing genius made Reba McEntire Colonel Sanders.
Oh, God. You did not go with Reba like that.
You're selling chicken.
Oh, Lord.
Bigger breast, bigger thighs, Dolly Parton. Sonic, supposed to be romantic throwback to the 50s, car hops, Route 66. And the best they can do is come up with two weenies in the front seat of a car. And the one that really pisses me off is that damn pig trying to sell me car insurance. You know the one I'm talking about? Her name's Flo?
Leave Flo out of this.
Aggressive is this Flo.
I was doing a show over here in Dallas not too long ago. There was a little old gal in there had on a skirt so short it damn near had a goatee.
Hello.
I ain't lying to you. Y'all ever been to the optometrist and had to do that little puff of air test? Little old gal did that to me and she says, "Well, Mr. Doll, there's no signs of glaucoma." Well, hell, there shouldn't be. I've been on the medication for decades. Took this old gal with me to the tractor show one time. Just like a car show. A lot of nice tractors, old ones, new ones. We were walking along there, and I said, "Now, damn, that tractor right there has got a good-looking rear end on it."
And she says, well, what kind of tractor does my little man remind you of? It's been a long time since that thing ran like a deer.
Oh, shit.
And I felt the chill. And I said, it's not like a Kubota, because Kubota's got a real narrow.
It won't work.
Hello.
And I heard the thunder. And I said, yours was more like a Massey. And that's the last thing I remember. This old gal used to live with infomercial on TV about titty tape. They call it breast risers. It's titty tape.
I don't know how this
goes. You take a titty and then you bring it up where you want it. And she says, I'm going to get me some of that. It's only $19.95. Now, there's no stopping her. So what does a good friend do? He gives her some advice. I said, well, you got him on the phone there. Said that, yeah, this on a 50-foot pole. And that's the last thing I remember. And when I got back, I spent a couple of days later. I knew it had come in. She looked like a mummy. Oh yeah, her titties were up here, her belly was back here, her butt was up here, all this was all pulled back. And then it come time for her to remove all that tape. And she had used it on hairier parts of her body. And I couldn't stop laughing. And that's the last thing I remember. Where are we at on time, sir?
Still rolling.
Still rolling.
You got 2 minutes.
I got how many?
2 minutes.
Two?
Hell, that's the last thing I remember.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Getting old sucks. It's my sweetheart. What's that? Stop at Walmart and get you a bag of prunes. I told you getting old sucks.
That's so romantic.
Breast reduction surgery? Well, I understand you're having trouble reaching your nipples, but you're not using them a lot, are you? You haven't stepped on getting in out of the tub, have you? And she hung up on me again. Let us pray. Dear Lord, please don't let that woman find out I did that bit. Because if she finds out, she'll be the one out there on that fucking tractor. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Junkyard Dog. May the good Lord pat back again. She should need. Damn, I give it up for Junkyard Dog, man. I appreciate that, man. That's great fucking comedy. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. Great comedy. I'm blessed to be in the same room with that man. Like I say, this man is the Richard Pryor of the trailer park.